There is no guarantee, and anyone who's been involved in vaccinology will tell you, that we will have a safe and effective vaccine. But we are cautiously optimistic. Working with the companies and the investment made by this Congress, hopefully there will be doses available by the beginning of next year.
We will ensure that our high levels of standards for safety and efficacy are met.
And to the commissioner's point, the FDA released new guidance on specific conditions that must be met for a COVID-19 vaccine to be approved. From the Washington Post, quote, any COVID-19 vaccine will have to prevent disease or decrease its severity in at least 50% of the people who receive it. Politico reports, quote, one of the leading vaccine candidates developed by NIH and Moderna is slated to begin phase 3 trials in July. Moderna's CEO has said that if early data is positive, it could begin dosing healthcare workers in the fall. With us again tonight, Dr. Mario Ramirez. He's an ER doctor currently treating COVID-19 patients. He's also former acting director for the White House Office of Pandemic and Emerging Threats, helping to lead the Obama White House's Ebola response. So, doctor, welcome. Thank you for joining us. Let me start with a layman's question here. I see a headline. I read a story that says the goal here is to get to at least 50% effectiveness with a vaccine. My reaction is, why? I take the shot and it's got a 50-50 shot of working. Is that too low?
That's a great question, Steve. You know, and I think what people should know is that that's actually okay. Historically, our influenza vaccines that we use year over year are only 40 to 60% effective. So that number of 50% is actually right in the middle of that. And I think that's a reasonable estimate to get to start with. You know, I think as we have subsequent vaccines, assuming that we get there, you know, the second and third iterations will get better. But starting with a goal of 50% is in line with what we used for influenza on an annual basis. You know, I think the context there is whether or not, you know, things are being rushed through too quickly. And I think using a goalpost like this, if that's really what the FDA sticks to, suggests that that's not the case.
So then we talk about there is this drug. There's a number of drugs being developed right now. I keep hearing reports from one or the other. But here's this one from Moderna that's about to enter phase 3 of its trials. First of all, this is the big one, phase 3, I always hear. What exactly does that mean?
It's another good question, Steve. So, you know, whenever we move a therapeutic or a vaccine through clinical trials, they go through 3 phases. So the first are phase 1 and 2. Those are really designed to test safety and in the first phase and whether or not you can give it to somebody and they don't have any side effects. But the second phase is whether it actually elicits the response in the body that you want. So if you're giving somebody a vaccine, does it actually produce antibodies? But phase 3 is really where we figure out in large groups of people, thousands of people, whether or not a vaccine or a therapeutic actually has the clinical effect you want. So that's what tells you whether or not giving a vaccine to somebody actually protects them from getting infected. So one of the interesting things that I think we heard at the hearing today, as well as in the last few days, is that we have several therapeutics that are coming to market. People have talked a lot about monoclonal antibodies and fresh frozen plasma. And then you referenced the Moderna vaccine. It's important to realize is that none of those treatments have gone through phase 3 trials yet. So we don't have good proof that they actually produce the clinical effect that we want.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.